I don't have all of the knowledge that these gentlemen have right now about the inner workings and all that's going on. They didn't give me a syllabus. I requested, they just laughed and turned away. But I am, one thing that I'm interested in trying to do, and it seems to me a no-brainer. I fear the objections that I'm going to hear. Bill Lee seems to be real interested in reigniting the vocational education in this state. I've already read an article in this last week or so where he was talking about building buildings again. That's fine, maybe, but that's a market's ebb and flow. Today we are in great need of skilled workers. In 20 years that may not be the case, but if we start building buildings all over the state, not only are we going to be saddled with the buildings and what to do with them, we're going to be saddled with the debt that it took to build them. I don't know that that's what we need to jump to right off the bat. Something that I'd like to see happen, if we could get the high school juniors and seniors, I'm not talking about the kids that want to get out of class early and go smoke cigarettes. If we can get the kids that are serious about their education, that are on track to graduate, paired up for say 4 weeks, 6 weeks at a time, whatever that balance is, get them out on a truck with a heating and air crew. Get them out on a truck with a plumbing crew. Get them down here with the fire department, the sheriff's office. Ride around with the medic crew. Wherever their interests lie, let's make a pathway. And we don't have to micromanage it from Nashville. We can untie the hands of the localities and turn them loose. If you're out in a rural area, it could be farming. If you're in a big city, you know, maybe it's a call center downtown. Manufacturing, if you're on a river, you know, whatever the case may be. Yeah.
One thing, and again, it's good to see you, Justin, now here is one of our representatives. I remember when you sat next to me in a class that we did here for the grassroots, training that they did
about a year and a half ago now.
Yeah, never knew you were going to be up in Nashville. But one thing, you know, sort of going off of that just sprang to me is, here in Knox County, you know, I remember when I was in high school, I was when the dual enrollment was really taking off. I had a lot of friends who did dual enrollment with community colleges, and go to Pell City and do that. I think something to that effect that might be worth exploring is letting kids do dual enrollment with the trades, you know, with the TCAT. You know, if they don't want to go on a collegiate track, they want to go on a trade school track, let them, you know, their last 2 years of high school, let them dual enroll in a TCAT and learn how to be, a diesel mechanic, you know, expand that. Because I know, and that lets them, in some cases, I think they can use Tennessee Promise on that. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I think that would be a really good way. And that way, when they come out of high school at 18, and they can work a trade. So
without any debt?
Yeah. I mean, that would be something. When you mentioned that, I thought,
I'm going to jump in here just 1 second. Yeah. I was going to add to that, you know, the registered nurse is just the RN, so GC at the hospital. That's a 2-year program.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And you can, you know, that's, you know, I'm always big on the healthcare thing, but let me tell you, those aren't jobs. Those are professions. Those are careers. And I think that's it's the same thing. Let them do a little shadowing people, send them over to the hospitals, and those 2-year nursing programs are just incredible. You got a good job when you finish, and you have a whole career in front of you, not just a job.
So I think
that's a good idea.
As we're moving into the Q&A portion, just a quick reminder, everybody be super respectful of one another, even if you disagree, because sometimes we all disagree, right? And then I want to kick off the first question, if anyone's got one, to Representative Dunn, because he's about to have to go. So whoever's got a burning question for Representative Dunn, please raise your hand so you can ask your question now. Any takers? Well, you got off the hook easy.